presentation, I will speak about a series of editathons that took place during this year in Italy, online, but metaphorically in Italy, because their main public is designed to be an Italian-speaking public, so metaphorically in Italy, and I will try to show the characteristics of these editathons, their achievements, what is still to be done in order to have them grow in number of people and in number of edits done on Wikidata. And before focusing on the editathons, I will speak about the Italian situation, in particular which are the main library catalogs and thus the main authority files in Italy, and which is their relationship with Wikidata. Of course, I will speak about library catalogs because our editathons focus mainly on librarians as a public, as editors, and on Wikidata items about people whose books are in Italian libraries. So it is important to understand what you are doing, also to know some aspects of the situation of the panorama of Italian libraries. So let's start. Italian library catalogs and authority files. The main actor in the panorama of Italian libraries is SBN. SBN is a collective catalog of Italian libraries, but it doesn't contain all the records of all Italian libraries, because as of now in Italy exist more than 12,000 libraries according to the National Registry of them, but only 6,500 participate in SBN, so a little more than half of the existing libraries. The participating libraries are mostly public libraries, while university libraries and ecclesiastical libraries, and also private libraries, tend to be outside SBN, although they could be part of SBN, and sometimes they are effectively. It is also to be said that when a library becomes member of SBN, it starts cataloging new books into SBN, but the books cataloged before have to be imported into SBN. It is obviously a difficult operation, because you should try to match the books that already are present in SBN with the books that are imported, and also the same for authority files, etc. So these imports sometimes are done after a certain time, or aren't done for a lot of time. So also for member libraries, it is not certain that all their books, all their bibliographic material is cataloged in SBN. Of course, SBN is a VIAF member. It represents the Italian libraries in VIAF, but it doesn't send all its authority data to VIAF, because SBN sends to VIAF only the authority records considered to reach a high quality standard, a very high quality standard, and for this reason only a small fraction of the personal authority records in SBN. This 4 million is an estimated number, but is probably more or less correct. What we know is that only nearly 200,000 of these personal authority records are sent to VIAF, and of course this is a problem because all the others, not only aren't sent to VIAF, but aren't shown to the public. And thus, since SBN, regarding Italian authors, has a lot of them which aren't present in foreign catalogs, if these authors are in the not accessible part of SBN, it is very difficult to map them on Wikidata. This is a problem. We are trying to convince SBN to show a higher, much higher number of authority records, but as of now we haven't achieved much. We are continue trying. We continue trying. The other important, most important actor in the Italian panorama, although not exactly in Italy, but in Vatican City, is the Vatican Apostolic Library, which is also a VIAF member, since it's authority data to VIAF. As of now, there are 300,000 personal authority records that are sent to VIAF, and of course, they are particularly valuable, especially for authors, Christian authors, and so on, but not only for them. In Italy, as we have said, half, a bit less than half of the libraries aren't part of SBN, so there are a lot of other catalogs, both collective catalogs and a lot of individual catalogs. About the collective catalogs, here are some examples that I cite because they had and they have an important relationship with Wikidata. Regarding bWeb, we can say that its authority data were recently imported, at least most of them, into Wikidata during a collaboration with Wikimedia Italy, while ShareCatalog and CogniSlot Portal, the first from some universities from southern Italy, while the second from some libraries around Turin, are projects that try to put together different catalogs of Italian libraries and to enhance the visualization of the information by the reader, adding a lot of data and identifiers from Wikidata. So both ShareCatalog and Cobis show Wikidata among the other identifiers, and from Wikidata extract the most important identifiers, such as VIAF, ISNI, or the link to Italian Wikipedia, etc., in order to show more information to the reader. To Wikidata, we have connected also 11 library catalogs from Italian libraries, which are all of them relatively small. They have about always fewer than 100,000 authority records. But they are valuable because they often cover, for example, Italian authors who have a certain importance but are in the not accessible part of SBN. And so, if it wasn't for these catalogs, would be very difficult to be mapped in Wikidata. So, also having these small library catalogs, these small authority files, allows us to have a deeper comprehension, a deeper comprehension of the panorama of the Italian authors. Complete list of these authority control properties can be found in the template Italy properties on Wikidata. So, in this very fragmented panorama, about 1 year ago, so in October 2020, the gruppo Wikidata per musei, archivi e biblioteche, Wikidata group for museums, archives and libraries started its activity. Our purposes are mainly instruct Italian cultural institutions and people working in Italian cultural institutions about the existence of Wikidata, which is not a fixed point for many people. Wikidata is still a name or also not a name. It is not known by many people. So Wikidata should be known, with a certain degree of precision, of detail, and in particular the cultural institution should understand the importance of linked open data and the central role of Wikidata in this galaxy of linked open data, and the cultural institution thus should start contribute to Wikidata, and on the other side use data from Wikidata in their websites in order to have something good from each other. So Wikidata receives the work from cultural institutions, and cultural institutions receive the data from Wikidata, not only those that they added, but also the data added by other people in a collaborative manner. So practically, the activities of our group, GVMAB, are the following: basic courses for people from cultural institutions. Of course, they are also open to everyone, but their main designed public is people from cultural institutions. Presentations of projects already realized in Italy on Wikidata. Conferences and meeting about Wikidata and cultural institutions, and the monthly editathons, about which we will now concentrate. The recordings of these activities are usually published on YouTube, and we have also a mailing list, social accounts, and a group on Telegram. So we also use these media in order to attract people and disseminate our activities. Of course, our activities as of now have been all online. We haven't done yet a meeting in person, and I don't know in person most of the members of our group, but we hope that during this year or the next we can start also doing something both online and in person. So, our monthly editathons. The main page of the monthly editathons is this. I can open it and then we can go back to it later. So, let's continue. The monthly editathons started in March 2021 and now are at the 7th edition that will take place tomorrow. They are each month the second Tuesday of the month. So the expected public are Wikidata users and librarians that in this occasion will become Wikidata users and hopefully will remain Wikidata users in the next months and years. And the edited items are persons whose works are present in the catalog of at least one Italian library. So, each edition focuses on one library catalog, so all the items on which people should work are items that share the presence of one specific identifier, that is the identifier of a specific authority file. In this way, we try also to attract specifically the librarians of this specific library, the librarians which manage this specific authority file, and it usually works. I think this is one of the characteristics of our editatons. And the editaton has the following parts in its page. I can also show them directly on the page of the first editathon. So we have this first part, the first part which is here, which contains basically instructions about how to do and what to do and how to do it, and links to longer versions of these instructions. This is the longer, but not so longer, and this is the longest one, this. So, instructions, then links to places where people can ask questions or discuss dubious cases, and finally, in this table, we have the queries, which contain the items to be enriched. And in this queries table, the users can sign in saying that they will work on a specific query from the top of the results or from the bottom of the results. In this way, we think we can mostly avoid the people overlapping on the same items. And we have the initial number of results of the query at the start of the day. Then we have the number of results at the end of the day, so we can somehow measure what has been done during the day of the editathon. Then I also measure the number of results at the end of the month, in order to see if people continued working somehow on these queries, or on the other side, the problems continue to increase without people working on decreasing them, and so the situation has worsened again. So it is also interesting seeing the results at the end of the month, although the editathon per se lasts one day. So this is basically the structure of the editathon. Now, the instructions guide the users, the longer version of the instructions guide the users in the setting of preferences and CommonJS in order to have them work in the best and quickest way possible. This is usually appreciated and has some effect, some positive effect. And then people can ask questions on Wikidata or on Telegram or in an online meeting at 17, in which we answer ourselves in a visible way the doubts that are exposed by the people who participate. So, our queries focus on four tasks that users should perform in these items. Adding via, of course, it is not always existent, but people should effectively look for it and verify that it doesn't exist, or if it exists, add it. Then missing birth that days, of course, not all the authors are dead, but all of them were born sometime, and so a date of birth, also a bit generic, should always be added. And then occupation and an Italian label. These are the tasks on which we want our users to focus, also because they are tasks that are relatively easy and so can be done with a relatively low Wikidata experience, also by librarians which start editing in this day or a few days before. We monitor the results through the number of results at the starting point of the day and at the end of the day. And the average decrease of results is 273 for about 10 or a bit less than 10 users participating each time. So each user solves about 30 problems, which is not bad. Of course, we can improve, but it is not bad. The total number of users which took part in at least one editions were 223. 9 are core members of GVMAB, so they count a bit less. One is me. Then there are 3 Wikidata users and 11 librarians, 8 of which belong to the a library's object of Editaton. So, as I said, one of our purposes is to involve these librarians from the library, which was the focus of a specific edition, and hopefully they will continue editing Wikidata also in the next months and years. The total decrease of results after the single days of the Editatons was this, 1,640. So 1,640 were the number of VIAF, birth dates, occupations, and Italian labels, which were added in 6 editions, which I think is not bad, although we can still improve. So, positive effects, of course, we want users to focus on data quality, so not only add items in order to improve the synchronization between my catalog and Wikidata, but also assure that the Wikidata items contain at least basic information that are needed to identify them, and these basic informations are mainly birth date, death date if necessary, occupation, VIAF if present, and so on. Of course, this information should be referenced, and this is another focus. Involve librarians, as I said, with the incentive of editing items which are crucial for their own library catalog, and so the specific library that took part in Wikidata, because it can also be helpful for improving its catalog. This is important. The queries we write down can be used also after the editathon, of course. What we want to do? These editathons in future, I hope, will be organized also in person, because having a direct contact with these librarians can be useful for many reasons, both because we probably have more fun, we will probably have more fun. I used to participate to in-person editathons and they were a very good experience. And also because explaining, for example, how to do a certain thing when the librarian has a doubt or so, can probably be easier in person than online sharing my screen. So I think that organizing this also in person can have many positive points. Then involve also foreign libraries. There are obviously many overlappings between the books owned by Italian libraries and books owned by foreign libraries, and so we can help each other also establishing these collaborations. Tomorrow edition will involve the Cyprus University of Technology, with which we had also contacts in the past months, and so we will start tomorrow with this. We want obviously to re-involve librarians that have already taken part in one edition in the next editions, so this should be improved, although it already happens sometimes. We want to involve more Wikidata users and Wikipedia users. We have to still publicize this more, and we hope to involve them. And we want to add queries that also, in the optic of data quality, queries that encourage people to focus not only on missing statements, but also statements that exist but lack references. When we took part in the last edition of One Lib One Ref, we had very good results in Italy, and so we think a bit of One Lib One Ref can also be injected into these editathons, these monthly editathons. Some final thoughts about the problems of libraries, not only in Italy. Libraries have few librarians, they have to work a lot, probably still a bit more during this pandemic, and often the sensibility for semantic web and linked open data is still to be improved, and if this sensibility is too low, also Wikidata will probably have a low interest for them. Another problem is that libraries are often interested to work in Wikidata when they see that the data they add to Wikidata can then be reused by them in their catalogs, that they can show them in their catalogs to their readers. But very often their ILS, so the information library system, the software that they use to display their catalog, doesn't allow to easily show to the readers data from Wikidata. And so I think that if in the near future we will be able, not only in Italy, because ILS are usually something that is multinational, that regards many countries, so the ILS are a small group of software that usually transcends, that usually validates the boundaries of different countries. And so if we can convince people developing this ILS that including the possibility to show data from Wikidata is important, then libraries will see this data coming from Wikidata, will understand that if they work on Wikidata, more data will come, more data and also data with a higher quality will come, and then it will be easier, I think, to establish collaborations with libraries. Of course, the browser extensions like Entity Explosion are a very good starting point. They can help showing to libraries what will be the near future, although it is not exactly here, but it will be soon here, and so libraries will probably understand and will be more willing to collaborate with the resources they have that are not so many, but libraries, if they understand that Wikidata has to be among the priorities, will find some resource to work on Wikidata and make Wikidata better, because they know that making Wikidata better will also make their catalogs, their authority file, better.